We talked about setting up bit rates and coming up with viable bit rate options for slower upload speeds in previous videos. But what if you know you have a capable internet connection, but you're still having trouble streaming with OBS Studio? Dropping frames, red connection status, and so on? Let's take a look at some options right after this. I'm EaplesVox, here to make tech easier and more fun, and welcome back to my OBS Studio tutorial course. I have many, many more videos on this software in the playlist link in the video description. Check that out if you have any questions. I probably answered them already, and I have an intro video explaining how this whole course works and a setup. First and foremost, please do realize that literally everyone's setup is different. Your internet provider, your internet connection, your router and other networking hardware, your computer, software running on your computer, your version of Windows, expectations, patience, and other devices on your network. Every tiniest detail of your setup will be different from everyone else's. Because of this, I will likely not have a single specified and directed answer that will fix your problems, but rather I aim to simply aid you along your way of troubleshooting what problems you might have. And remember, OBS does have a dedicated forum you can use to submit logs and specs to try to get a solution to your problems too. As with all complicated streaming setups, patience is very important. I also wanted to point out the new connection status indicator. This came out in update 18 in the software and brought back a feature that had died with classic OBS until March-ish 2017. At the bottom, where it shows your current frame rate in OBS Studio, it now shows a color indicator for network stability. Green means no congestion, everything is good. Yellow indicates increasing congestion, it's having more trouble pushing the full bitrate through consistently. Red means it's dropping frames due to network issues. Tip number one, plug in an Ethernet cable. No, really. Wireless networking has come a long way in terms of raw deliverable speeds, but it's still crap for high-level work. It can increase your ping and is very prone to signal interference, signal degradation, and packet loss. Use your attics, basements, walls, something, and get a wired network going to your streaming setup if you're getting serious about streaming. Plus, when you try to narrow down troubleshooting, virtually no one will help you if you say you are on wireless and haven't recreated it with a wired network connection yet. Just a factor of life. It's the lowest common denominator. Tip number two. An obvious one, but one everyone skips, including myself. And then you feel bad about it. Turn off unnecessary services and programs. If you're not running a Steam game, a Battle.net game, an Origin, Uplay, or whatever service platform game, don't run the clients. Auto-updating for games or the app itself can kick in at any time and ruin your network performance. Similarly, close out of just about everything else. Skype constantly loads ads and uses network traffic. Cloud sync apps are constantly pinging and syncing data. BitTorrent and Usenet clients are always active. Overbearing firewalls and network monitors can cause your performance to degrade too. If this is too difficult to pull off every time you want to stream, consider making a new user profile on your computer just for streaming. Only install exactly what you need for streaming, and then don't ever use it other than for streaming. Tweak it to prevent extraneous processes from starting up and signing in, and keep it clean and easy to use. Tip number three, check your streaming servers. Make sure you're not set to stream to a Twitch or YouTube or whatever service across the world. The closer you can get to your exact location, the better. The auto configuration tool we covered in a previous episode has a built-in tool to ping servers for your streaming service and choose the right one for you. Try that too. Tip number four, use OBS's new network tools. In Settings, Advanced, OBS Studio has new networking options available at the bottom. If you have multiple networking devices connected to your PC, for example a wireless card and a wired Ethernet jack, you can use the Bind to IP dropdown to force OBS to only use one device, preferably your Ethernet connection, and prevent it from accidentally routing through wireless or something like that. This is also useful if you run separate internet connections entirely for streaming and other network usage. You can try checking the box next to Enable New Networking Code to see if it plays better with the stream servers. The code is supposed to help stream more efficiently, though not much information is given about it. If you do check that box, you also have the option to check the box next to Low Latency Mode, which will stream in a more ping-friendly way to keep ping down. This will, however, use more system resources, but might be the fix that you need. You also have controls for auto reconnect settings here as well. Tip number five. Lastly, if you're consistently having issues streaming and your bitrates are well within your bandwidth, check with your ISP. Give them a call and work with them to stress test your modem, router, and networking hardware to see if you're having any signal loss, packet loss, or other connection issues that might be directly associated with them. While this was more of a problem in older dial-up and DSL networks, this can still very much be the source of many streamers' headaches. And be nice to your ISP employees. Again, have some patience and work through each step carefully and with multiple trials. You'll get it worked out. Sometimes it just takes time. Hopefully these tips have helped you along your way. Have you had any oddball network fixes? Leave them in the comments below. I hope this episode of my OBS Studio tutorial course has been helpful for you. If it was, dropkick that like button, get subscribed for more awesome tech content, come follow me on Twitch if you like game streaming, and come say hello in chat. Until next time, I'm Maples Fox. Happy streaming!
Thanks for watching this episode of my OBS Studio tutorial course. More videos like this and a full master class are linked in the playlist in the video description. Click to learn more.